Okay, so if you reverse time, then the universe is getting smaller.
All right.
So what if I reverse the process all the way back to see what happened at the beginning of time itself?
What if everything we thought we knew about the cosmos, from its age and expansion to its very existence, is only a partial truth? What if the universe is twice as old as our calculations suggest? A riveting new study poses these audacious questions, contending that the universe might not be 13.8 billion years old, but up to 26.7 billion years old. This breathtaking assertion forces us to confront the very bedrock of cosmological understanding that we've held for years. Yet, as renowned astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson reminds us, such groundbreaking propositions must face the crucible of empirical examination before gaining scientific acceptance.
If you have an idea about something, then you test it multiple ways and get other people to test it. And if the tests give you consistent results, you have a new understanding of the universe. When that happens, that knowledge of the universe doesn't go away. It doesn't get undone. What happens typically is you have a deeper understanding of the universe in which that understanding gets embedded. And you realize that you only understood a small part of a larger whole. But the small parts you did understand, where you had multiple experiments that confirmed it, that doesn't change. You have to use a deeper understanding.
Our understanding of the cosmos is, after all, predicated on a ceaseless quest for knowledge, fueled by an enduring spirit of skepticism and curiosity. The idea of revisiting the universe's age isn't novel. In fact, the history of cosmology is rich with radical revisions. Back in the 1920s, Edwin Hubble estimated the universe's age to be a mere 2 billion years old. We've refined our method since then, but the thought of doubling the age of the universe proposed a significant paradigm shift, a departure from what we've conventionally held to be true. One key area that might catalyze this reassessment involves the intriguing concept of black hole singularities. According to Einstein's general relativity, the existence of black holes necessitates the presence of singularities, points of infinite density where our familiar physics collapses. These singularities are cosmic enigmas that challenge our current understanding, alluding to states of existence fundamentally unexplainable with our prevailing theories. In this enigma lies an exciting opportunity. What if unraveling the mystery of black hole singularities sheds light on the universe's birth? If we comprehend the operation of physics under these extreme conditions, could we gain insights into the universe's nascent stages when it existed in an unimaginably dense and hot state? Could the perceived discrepancy in the universe's age be reconciled by studying these enigmatic singularities?
You get black holes from Einstein. Center black hole is a singularity. All the theories say the matter occupies zero volume, thereby having infinite density. And that's kind of weird. What? No, you can't have infinite. No. That's a limit of Einstein's theory. So in Einstein's equations, we're dividing by zero at the singularity. So we all know that as brilliant as Einstein was, and as successful as his general theory of relativity has been, it has limits. And one limit is the center of a black hole, and another limit is the very birth of the universe itself. So, we have top people working on trying to resolve this singularity problem. And in so doing, you get to some ideas that, well, maybe our Big Bang, because the Big Bang is not going to go away. All the data support this. So now I've got this Big Bang thing, okay? And, well, is this embedded in something bigger? So when you put like quantum physics and general relativity and you try to come up with some bigger understanding, deeper understanding, string theorists have been all into this, you get a multiverse. Came out of the equations. So how old is the multiverse? I don't know. It's definitely older than our universe because it birthed our universe and it births other universes and it births, the way the equations drive it, an infinity of universes. And so that is what comes out of the equations. So that makes the Big Bang a kind of a small part of a much larger whole. But the fact that the universe had a beginning 14 billion years ago, and there's the cosmic microwave background, all of these features are intact. They're not going to all of a sudden not apply.
A potent concept that could throw light on this enigma is the theory of cosmic inflation. It posits an extremely rapid exponential expansion of the universe prior to the more linear expansion we observe today, all taking place a fraction of a second after the Big Bang. This brief but monumentally significant period is believed to have ironed out the primordial wrinkles and irregularities, resulting in the astonishingly uniform cosmos we see around us. Inflation theory doesn't merely reshape our understanding of the universe's beginnings, it might hold clues to its age. It challenges the conventional Big Bang timeline, stretching the cosmic clock backwards into an epoch of ultra-fast expansion. This could, theoretically, allow the universe to be many billions of years older than the age deduced from standard Big Bang cosmology.
13.8 billion years since the Big Bang, and so there's a finite distance you can see because light travels at a finite speed. So we're very sure that there are galaxies way beyond our horizon, but essentially the light has not had time to reach us from them. So we have a theory called eternal inflation, which essentially leads to the idea that there are perhaps an infinite number of bubble universes, of which ours is one. And the piece that we can see, the observational, the little piece we can observe, is a patch in one bubble universe amongst perhaps an infinite number of bubble universes in the inflationary multiverse. And those theories do lend themselves, potentially, to the laws of nature in each bubble possibly being different.
But inflation theory is not without its controversies. While it helps explain many cosmological observations, direct evidence of inflation remains elusive. Future gravitational wave detectors, or more detailed maps of the cosmic microwave background, might finally reveal the imprints of this epic cosmic event. For about two decades, the scientific community has agreed that our universe is approximately 13.8 billion years old. Yet, evidence gathered from the advanced ages of certain stars and the substantial masses of early galaxies has begun to stir doubts. A new study from the University of Ottawa presents a fresh angle, utilizing the theory of tired light and fluctuating constants to suggest that the universe could be significantly older, 26.7 billion years to be exact. Lengthening the universe's age could illuminate numerous cosmic conundrums, including new mysteries unearthed by NASA's James Webb Space Telescope. Methuselah, one of the oldest known stars, mysteriously appears to be older than the universe itself. While this assertion seems impossible, accounting for margins of error might imply that its formation predates the Big Bang. Methuselah isn't alone. Recent data from the JWST reveals at least six galaxies whose massive size seems inconsistent with the universe's timeline. However, theories, regardless of how revolutionary, require empirical substantiation. As Tyson emphasizes, a wealth of evidence, from the clarity of distant galaxies to the time dilation of cosmic events, the blackbody spectrum of the cosmic microwave background, and the consistency of fundamental constants on Earth, all point to a universe that's approximately 13.8 billion years old.
The age of the universe, round it to 14 billion years. That's called deep time, and no one even thought anything in the universe was as old as that until relatively recently, in the last 150 years or so. Think of all of the history of civilization and what our understanding was about time. Part of the problem is we think cosmic time intervals somehow matter to human time intervals, and they don't. The universe has spent nearly two-thirds of its life without the solar system. You have to slowly make the heavy elements from the light elements. All that happened in the first 3 minutes. Okay, well, you made hydrogen, and then you start making stars after the dark ages. The James Webb Space Telescope is exquisitely tuned to look just at the end of the dark ages, in the early universe where we had matter and energy, but no stars yet, and then assemble into galaxies and have enough of these to make enough heavy elements to make planets. Because planets have a lot of heavy elements in them, and they're made in the centers of stars. That takes time. We are second, third generation star system that made the sun. And we see stars being born today, looking deep inside gas clouds. When those stars have planets in orbit around them, all of them made of the heavy elements that occurred later.
While the theory of a 26.7 billion-year-old universe can offer some intriguing solutions to cosmological issues and has its place within the speculative realm of multiverse theories, the preponderance of evidence currently aligns with the widely accepted age of the universe being around 13.8 billion years. Therefore, it remains highly unlikely, based on our current understanding and available evidence, that our universe is 26.7 billion years old. Nevertheless, science is ever evolving, and it thrives on challenging established ideas and exploring new frontiers. Thus, while we operate with the best models and theories available to us now, the future of cosmological research could yet surprise us with revolutionary discoveries.